What's up, athletes? Welcome back. We have CyclePower on the menu, one of my personal favorites. You guys know I love to ride the bike, and of course you guys know I love music. So bringing those two things together is gonna be legendary. Here's what you can expect to see. We have 45 minutes of our ride together. It's pretty much gonna be on the tip of the music. A couple times, I'm gonna ask you to go just above the music or just below the music for those big breathless intervals. But for the majority of time, you can expect to find the rhythm as we start to ride. Now, no matter if you're at home or if you're at a gym or a club, just know that we're gonna be going big with some of these music bangers. So you might need to get a little bit loud here. I know you're gonna sing back with me. It's gonna be great. That's pretty much it. That's all I got for you. So without further delay, let's get on the bike now. All right, team, let's go and get started, shall we? Let's find ourselves onto your bike. And I want you to go ahead and start to take all your resistance over to the left side until you have zero resistance on that flywheel. So we can all start on the exact same road. From here, begin to turn that resistance knob, hard turns over to the right side until the bike gives you a little feedback, a little push, a little sizzle, a little substance. Now I need for you to join me at about 95 RPMs, right? Easy resistance on the flywheel for now, but we're gonna change that as we start to go and warm up this body, all right? So right here, I want you to find that tempo music, that right, left, one, two, one, two, one, two. Begin to shift your hips towards the back end of your saddle. So your tail comes to the most meaty part of the saddle. Walk those hands to the one position, palms open. From here, begin to wiggle your digits, relax. Take one single arm, begin to rock it forward and back, releasing the tension from the shoulders, upper neck, cervical, hands go back to center. Same thing on the other side, arms go forward and back. All right, walking those hands out a little bit wider, coming to that two position. Tuck your chin to your chest, begin to shake your head down. Now begin to nod your head yes. Once again, releasing tension from the neck, head, and shoulders. Exhaling, and I want you to push your gaze about 2 to 3 feet in front of you. It creates a little bit of space between your chin and your chest. That way you can get some more air into your lungs and exhale without any obstruction, all right? Now right now, what I want you to do, take a moment and opportunity to visualize yourself at the end of today's ride. How do you want to finish? Do you want to finish a little stronger, a little lighter, a little brighter? Whatever your finish move is, that finish person, I want you to visualize that person, tattoo it into your memory bank, because we're not just going to find them, we're going to become them, we're going to celebrate them. All right? So know that this is your opportunity to be a little stronger, be a little bit better than you were any other time in your life. Now, from here, we're gonna put a little bit more sizzle on the flywheel. So you can turn your resistance knob over to the right side until you come to maybe a 2 out of 5. Let's say that 5 was the most amount of resistance you could hold on to. This 2 should feel moderate, right? There's places that you can go a little bit higher, but right now, you can feel that road resistance against you, something you can hold on to for maybe about 2 to 3 minutes. We're only gonna be here for about 90 more seconds. All right, my friends, right now we're gonna take an opportunity to begin to build up that heat even further. The way we're gonna do that, we're gonna pick up our pace, move just a little bit faster. In 4, 3, 2, for 30 seconds, begin to pick up your pace, move in front of the music. Can you bring your tempo pace into the triple digits? Maybe 100, maybe 105, but I don't necessarily need to go past 110. Notice that shift in the intensity, even though we didn't touch our gear. We have about 10 more seconds here. We're just basically running our way to the base of our very first hill. We're gonna slow down our pace in 3, 2, come back to that tempo pace. Well played, guys. Now, body's starting to feel a little bit more awake. Definitely don't need you breathless, but you should feel a little bit of pace that feels warmer. We make our way to the end of this flat road into the beginning of our very first hill. Begin to build your resistance, hard turns over to the right side until your tempo pace comes to about 65 to 70 RPMs. Now, it should have enough resistance on your flywheel you feel okay to come up out of your saddle. Walk the hands to the top with your rise right here. Here we go. Now looking for your hips to be over top of the heels. Belly button in towards your spine. Upper body nice and light. We're gonna come to a bit of a rough terrain. You're gonna slide your hips back for 8 counts. Coming to have trouble back. In 4, 3, 2, bring it back. Goes 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Take it forward, back into that center. Do that again, take it back, 8. Draw the shoulders back. Back to the center. Let's cut everything in half. 4 for 4, here we go. 4, 3, 2, 1, back center. Back. And center. 2 more, take it back. And center. 1 more time, take it back. And center. Hold center, hold it right here. Well done, guys. So good. So, I want you to think of this hill as a continuation of your warm-up. We started on our flat. We're kind of a bit of a baby hill, right? Definitely not our hardest work. We always have room to grow, but it's enough to start to wake up our body and our breathing. Now we're gonna come to a steeper part of this hill. So I need you to reach down for me. Give yourself maybe a quarter turn, maybe it's a half turn, whatever that turn is. Make it enough that you can actually subtly feel the change in the terrain. Now, the last time we did the travel back, we started with our 8, went to our 4s. This time we're gonna go 4 into the 2s, all right? In 4, 3, 2, take it back. It goes 4, 3, 2, 1, take it back to the center. Back. Center. 2 more, take it back. Center. 1 more time. I need my 2 for 2s. Here we go. Back 2. Center. Back 2. Center. Show me that 4 more times, guys, right here. 1, 2, 3. Last one, 4, hold center right here, hold it. Come on. You're doing great. Maybe you started to break your very first sweat, but it definitely won't be the last. 4, 3, 2, keep your resistance the same, come into your saddle. Change your tempo pace. We're gonna move just a little bit faster up this road. So same terrain that we've seen, we're just moving up it a little bit faster, right? I need you to find that tempo pace, 75 to 80 RPMs, closer to 75 to 80, please. We have about 3 minutes here, just a little above. I want you to think of this as your jogging hill, right? So we're on that same terrain that we saw from before, we're moving a little faster, going from a walk or a climb, into the jog. Now good news for you. Complicated maybe. The resistance is gonna go up because the terrain is gonna change. We're gonna give ourselves a hard turn resistance to the right. We're gonna make our way above our saddle and we attack. Now your tempo will slowly sink. 75 to 80 RPMs. We just change that resistance. Begin to reach down, bend over, make it strong. Hands to the top. Rise right here. Come on. Hup. I got you. Stay with me halfway there. Breathing should become more labored. And back may become harder. In 4. In 3. Whatever resistance you added, take it off. Come back into your saddle, hold level. Well done, guys. We'll roll past that warm up. We're now in this work, right? I don't know about you, but I've already broken a sweat. I invite you to join me here. Here's the deal. Round 2, similar to round 1, guys. Except for this time, we're gonna be there just a little bit longer than we were the first time. Now, wherever resistance you took off last time, I need you to put it back on, find your saddle, right here, here we go. Push.
last time was about 20 seconds, we were out of our saddle. This time, we're just above 20 seconds, but just under 30. Come on. So strong. I'm gonna call you back home. In 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, back into your saddle, whatever resistance you added, take it down. Finish the hill. Four, three, two, one. Resistance comes down, find a flat road. Well done, guys. Fast through the water. Well played. Okay, kids. Welcome to your 2020s. Here's what you can expect to see. Resistance now. I need you about that 2 out of 5 that we saw before. Moderate. Pick up your tempo pace. About 100 RPMs right here, right now. Let's go. Now you're here for about 20 seconds. Then we're gonna dial up that resistance, coming to maybe a 3 out of 5. So you go from moderate to hard. Let's get ready to make that change in 4, 3, 2, come into hard resistance right here. You have 20 seconds here. Elbows are softened, heart is lifted. 10 seconds down. Keep it going, guys. We're gonna go heavier on that resistance. Go to a 4 out of 5, right now. Bring it to 4 out of 5, which means it should feel really hard to hold on to the tempo, but it's hard that we can maintain. You're here for only 20 seconds. Shh, breathe out. 3, 2, 1, dial it back. Go back to that 2 out of 5. So that's it, you know what to do. But now is about dialing it in and getting it done. 20 seconds moderate, 20 seconds hard, 20 seconds very hard. Let's get ready to go back into that hard. Right here, right now, turn it up. Ah, so back to that 3 out of 5. Should feel hard, and your breathing should match that hard. Exhale. I got you. Very hard resistance in 3, 2, 1. Turn it up. Very hard. You're at that 4 out of 5. You should be battling the bike. You should be winning that battle. 10 seconds now. We're gonna pull it back. 4, 3, 2, 1, dial it back. Well done. We're gonna do that just maybe 2 more times, guys. 10 seconds. Four, three, two, dial it up right here, go. So we're back to that 3 out of 5. Press feet hard. Oh yeah, let's come on. Push. Drive into the pedals, make it yours. Your time, your ride, need you to own it. Get harder. Right now, go to harder. You have only 20 seconds here. Yes, you can. Yes, you will. I believe in you. I need you to finish it. You're halfway there. 4, 3, 2, 1, dial it down. Last time, guys. Last time. Okay, 10 seconds. You're back from that easy or moderate into hard. 4, 3, 2, dial it up right here, go. Woo. This is a burner, guys. 10 seconds. 4, 3, 2, last time, very hard, go, go. To the end, my friends. 10 more seconds. four, three. Keep your resistance you have, slow down your tempo. Wow. Well done, my friends, well done. All right, quick drink of water. Then I need you to quickly find the tempo of music. Now I want you to notice, we kept the same resistance we had last time, right? So, the resistance should feel, I'm gonna put this a little more on, hard, but we have a new tempo. We're about 80 to 85 RPMs. Closer to 80 to 85. Enough that we feel good to come up out of our saddle. We rise on my count. Four, three, two. Move out of your saddle right here, let's go. Hold right here. And we're gonna tap into your inner rock star. You're gonna drop those elbows, elbow drops. Here we go, drop. Get it. You have four, three, two, one. Come back to your saddle. Woo. All right. How'd that first one go? Pretty good, right? And if it didn't feel good, no worries. There's always a second chance at redemption, guys. Same drill, slightly skewed. I need you to put just a subtle amount of resistance on your flywheel, right here. Make your way out of your saddle, right here. Let's go. So keep up those beautiful pedal strokes. Maintain your same integrity of your form. Hips over top of the heels. Belly button in towards your spine. Let's do those elbow drops. Just a little longer. Elbow drop, ready? Here we go, drop. Hey. You're dropping those elbows straight down towards the floor. Hips are still over top of the heels. We're halfway there, come on. I want you to imagine you're moving over a rocky terrain. This bounce is all about conquering it. Four, three, two, back to saddle. Now that subtle change I asked you to put on, you can take it off. All right, my friends, unhinge if you need to. Tile it off. We get one more. Now, whatever resistance you took off last time, we're gonna run back on. Let's begin to turn on. Turn up that volume. Find that subtle change. Hands to the three position. We rise on my count. Three, two, rise for me right here. Come on. Hey. Ready for elbow drops? Let's go. Huh. Yes. You got it. Three, two, one. Right back into that saddle. Holy cow. Woo-wee. Hey, take an opportunity. Put your hands together. Absolutely phenomenal work. You totally crushed that ride. You made it yours. You did it very, very well. You did it excellently. And I could not be more proud of you. So, I want you to be proud of yourselves. And one more time, put your hands together. Know that you absolutely crushed it, all right? Cool. Great work, everybody. Arms up to the side. Shake out those arms. Begin to bend the elbows. Roll the shoulders forward. Roll the shoulders back. Now, if you're visiting us on social media, I want to say thank you so much for joining us. Arms out to the side, turn your palms down. And if you would like to enjoy the entire ride, be sure to join us on Patreon. For those of us on the Patreon page, amazing work. Would love to be able to hear back from you guys here, not just from social media, but also from Patreon. Ear to the shoulder, which track was your favorite? Maybe which drill was the most challenging for you? So it's all about the feedback, right? I want to hear back from you guys. This is an open conversation, so please, please, please. Leave a couple comments in the comment section. Begin slow down your pedal strokes. All right, feet are nice and parallel. Stand by your saddle. Draw your heels down towards the floor. Press your hips back. You should feel a deep stretch behind the hamstrings. Tuck the chin to the chest. Shake that elbow. releasing that cervical spine once again. Surprisingly, we do hold a lot of tension there. Shift hips forward, draw the shoulders down your back, open up the heart. Well done. Let's do the same thing on the other side, heels down, hips back, chin to the chest. This time now you have yes. It's an affirmation that yes, you actually get everything you possibly have. And at the top of today's class, I ask you guys to visualize the strongest version of yourself. Hopefully you feel just like that person. Know that you are that person that you visualize. If you visualize it and put words into action, then you can always achieve anything. All right? Thank you so much for joining us. I will see you next time. One more time, be sure to leave a couple comments in the comment section. Get out of here, guys. Enjoy the rest of your day. We'll see you next time.